short jump. We're gonna have to do a short jump.
Okay.
Once. So basically, if you zoom out really far, like you're sitting on the sun, all you see when you zoom into the Earth, it's going to be 8 minutes late. So if you were a huge giant living on the sun, your eyeball was zoomed in on the Earth, and you'd be 8 minutes behind everyone else. So maybe I'm a giant. Maybe that's why I'm 8 minutes late for everything. Yeah, it would be so cool if there are like super-sized aliens somewhere out there. Like, there's some species of alien that is just like 100 times, 1,000 times, 1,000,000 times bigger than like the range of normal life that we're used to. I need to turn around, so I jump the other way. It's daylight savings time travel. I've always thought, what would it be like if maybe there were like, if evolution had happened different on Earth, could there have been a timeline where like we basically had ants? Oof, that's the play right there. No, that would not be cool. I mean, they might be scary, I guess, but if they're far away from us, maybe it'd be cool. There we go. I'm learning how to do this in like one motion. Turn around, small jump. There we go. Can't make Yoshi not hop here. So we'll just go down here. And then this is one of those medium-sized jumps, I think. Oh, I can make that with a regular. I don't even need a medium. Okay. I'm learning. Whoops. Man. What is the coin over the cloud? It's a different way to play it. I'm just trying to do it a little faster by skipping that section. But you could sort of take your time and not skip that section and go up there instead. There we go. Got that down. This is kind of awkward. There we go. It's actually not so bad. I'm gonna have to jump up there and grab that shell. And then my assumption is I kick the shell. Since Yoshi can't hold the shell in his mouth, my assumption is I jump up there, grab the shell. Do I have to just do it really fast? And then I kick the shell to the right, and then I think I'm just gonna jump on it. That's what looks right to me. There probably is a Yoshi world with Yoshi streamers playing Super Yoshi World. I wonder how the dog sentient species would differ as a society, right? Or like the cephalopod society? How cool would that be? I want like a giant squid society. I'm not sure if I can stay up there safely. I could spin, I guess. Can I spin? Yeah. I think I have to spin. Okay, I gotta spin for a second. Unless I'm missing something, which could be the case there. Now that I know what I'm doing there. Alright, here we go. I want cats. Domesticated humans. Cuttlefish boys of cephalociety. Plants and animal cells are fundamentally different. They are, but there's no reason in my mind to think that plants couldn't have formed multicellular, like, sentient beings. It just depends on, like... Yeah, I mean, I guess the fact that they're stationary maybe made it less less useful, but they don't have to be stationary. All right, let's see. So I don't know what I'm gonna do here. YOLO. Nailed it. Why didn't I grab it? I don't know what went wrong there. There's something else I should do instead of that. Am I being dumb here? It definitely looks like that's what I do to the right, though. Why doesn't it go up? Maybe I have to turn left and then do it. I think I'm kicking it into the wall and I forgot about No, this Yoshi doesn't have a tongue. Or at least a usable tongue. Different species of Yoshi. Let's see. But I am not doing this well. I think it's just a different Yoshi species. Why you guys gotta be so grim about it? Right. I'm not doing that part right. Anybody have ideas? I don't know what the idea is there. Where to find the ROMAC? SMWcentral.com.net? I don't remember. It does have a tongue. It's just human-sized. .net. Thank you. You can find it on there. Google Grim Pool World 3, and you'll probably get it. Let's see. How do I do this? I don't understand. Maybe just go faster. Oh, what if I come in from the side, actually? Yeah, maybe that's... Oh! Oh! Wait, why does that go... But then the Yoshi's not quite in the right spot. Oh, no. This is one of those sections where, like, I know there's a smooth setup for it, and I'm not seeing it. There has to be a smooth setup for that. Don't land on the block and just grab on the jump. Oh, I see what you're saying. I thought I couldn't do that, but maybe I can. This Yoshi does jump really high. Maybe it'll work somehow. Okay. Didn't work there, but maybe we'll try again. No, I'm not. Yeah, I'm not able to do it. I might just be spaghettiing the inputs, but I don't grab it. What if I get it? Like, what if I get it and jump over the saw? Maybe that's the play. Yeah, let's try that. I just do it like that. All right, cool. That's how you do it. That's how you do it. I was overcomplicating it. It wasn't too bad at all. I don't think the timing's that tight. I think I just have to do a... You can kind of float in the air by releasing and repressing the jump button. And if I do a little floaty jump, I should just be able to float over that part and get it. I think that's the play. The jump! Alright, how am I gonna not make Yoshi jump? I gotta do a test. If I jump down onto Yoshi, okay, yeah, it's because I'm holding to the side. I have to release the D-pad as I collide with Yoshi, or else Yoshi does the small hop. I'm not pushing jump, just pushing left or right, left, right makes Yoshi do the little hop, and I don't want Yoshi doing that while I'm trying to land on the shell. I did it again! Come back! My brain just can't. The Yoshi hop is cute. Aw. Can't not do it. It's in my brain from, like, how I would normally play the game. Whoops. Madeline Squish, yes. Please. Please. Oh. Yeah, this is very not normal. This is cool though. I'm starting to get a handle on it, and it's kind of fun. Walks off edge. This is definitely something that the difficulty is not conveyed though, I think, to the viewer who like doesn't understand what inputs are needed to make this work right. Why didn't that jump? Oh, because I released the D-pad, that's why. Yeah, there it is. It's like my brain adapts, and then my brain unadapts, and it's like, why are we doing this? Whoa, I dodged all of them. That's pretty crazy. Okay, remember in my brain. There it is. Oh my gosh, no! Yeah, the music's great, I agree. That's what we want though. That is what we want. Well, whoops. We're fine, I'm sure. No, there was no way. I'm trying to backseat. So, I don't want any spoilers for new content, but about the current section, you're more than welcome to suggest ideas to do stuff better. You feel like you can see music and this track and background just work together. I really like the background with this track as well. I'm getting so fast at like getting Yoshi up there that it's actually like I'm getting more speed and Yoshi's getting further to the right and it's actually making it harder. I need to just like slow that part down a little bit. Then I have way more time to react to that. Okay. Gotta jump fast there. I can still do a small jump. Alright, cool. Yeah. Hop, hop, hop. There we go. Stay on the saw this time. Big jump. Big jump. Oh, geez. What am I doing with that P-switch? What am I doing with that P-switch? I could jump off the Yoshi. I don't know what I'm doing with that P-switch. Yeah, this level's very chill. It is. You can't use this Yoshi. This Yoshi doesn't have a long tongue. So we can't do any tongue stuff with it. I did the thing. I think I just kick it straight up and it'll activate the P-switch as the P-switch falls back down. It's kind of a thing that is used in SMW frequently in ROM hacks. It's just a piece. It's just a mid-air P-switch jump. Oh, Yoshi can't. Oh, I can't touch those blocks. That's right. So. Oh. Is it the P-switch? Can I stay on the Yoshi? slightly confused. It might be a pizza shop. bar, what are you doing? I don't know. Whoops. Ideas for that P-switch part? A little bit confuzzlinated about whether I'm supposed to hit the P-switch or jump off of it. Can you get to the right of the saw to get a bit more time in that section? I was thinking that too, that maybe I can hit it. I just don't know what I'm doing to the right. Like, what I don't quite understand what I need the P-switch for, which is part of the problem. What am I... Is maybe blocks are gonna appear? Thinking that. The thing is, so if I jump up and hit it, if I jump up and release the block, is it gonna fall in time for me to use it? This Yoshi is floaty, so maybe, but if you throw it up right away, will it hit? Will it land, do you mean, maybe? Yeah, I don't know. We'll try some of that stuff. I think we just experiment more. Be there further. I don't understand. So what happened was I hit the block with my head. Can I bonk on it before jumping? Did I bonk off of it before jumping? Yeah. I bonk the thing while I'm on Yoshi. Maybe I need to land back on the saw. Okay, I think I have to do that section faster and land back on the saw. That's my best guess. And then I'll be able to jump back over to the P-switch. And then we hope that... I don't know. Then we hope that it's not just a straight jump. Because jumping off of a P-switch is easy in Mario Maker and is not easy in vanilla SMW. Yeah, normal jumps, if they're not modified, are single frame jumps. I've seen some P-switches that I was using in a hack I was working on that are much easier to jump off of. Maybe Yoshi can auto-jump off the P-switch. That's a really good point, too. That's a really good point, too, because this Yoshi does do... Wait, the Yoshi does do frame one jumps, right? If I'm holding left and right? So maybe it's just the Yoshi that's going to have an easy time with it. That makes sense. Yeah, that makes sense. That's only going to work if I can get there faster, though. So we got to figure out how to do that first. Oh, that was it. Okay, that has to be it. That felt right. And I don't know what's going to happen after that, but hopefully something will present itself that will make sense. The Yoshi just auto jumps off of it, and I have the whole jump, and we'll be good. Let's go. Let's go. That's what it is. That's cool. But I still have to get the right size jump off of it. Oh man. Frame perfect Yoshi. There's no obvious path. Trust in Barb. There's an obvious path. Do not trust in Barb. You know what? That is an actual... That is actual wisdom right there. I should have dropped my jump right there. I'm slowly getting a hang of this Yoshi, but there's still some parts that are like... My brain knows what to do, but my hands don't want to do it. Because it's like, feels a little bit weird. So it's like I have to convince them. A little slow here, but maybe. Let's go. Ah! I need to do a re-grab. The like mid-air Yoshi re-grabs are weird. They're also not weird. The physics of this thing are like actually really good. Once I can get my brain to like actually do it right. Whoops. Oh, we're alive. Let's go. Didn't do a big jump there. Mandatory jump. That's a free jump, thankfully. No, I knew what to do. I knew what to do. Gotta do a big one there. In order to do that big one, I have to release the D-pad when I land on Yoshi. It's the same jump as that one right there. Oh, I stubbed my toe. Both IRL and on Yoshi. Only when you hear the jump sound am I actually pushing the jump button, by the way. So for any of the Yoshi hops that you don't hear the jump sound, I haven't actually pushed a jump button. Stubbed my heel that time. It's a re-grab, and then a release. Darn. Grand Poo 3 is going great. We made a bunch of progress today. I feel really good about our progress today. We beat the, like, hellish ice level, and then we did, like, a really cool VVVVV level, and then we did a really cool Yoshi level, and now we're on another very chill Yoshi level, which is honestly really nice. This is just a nice break. I feel like Barb's pacing has been really good. Like, the boss fight on the VVVVV level was, like, the perfect break after ice hell for the rest of that world. Shoutouts to D for... that section. time here. There it is. Oh my gosh. And then I have to land on that. Bounce on that guy. Will that net... anybody know if that net that we saw at the end at the top is going to... is going to kill Morio? Not sure if it will or not. I kind of get confused about those sometimes. I feel like it will, but where else do I go then? How difficult was the airship puzzle for you to figure out? Chat helped me with it. But it was technically... So I found the door above the end. And then one of my mods was like, I wonder if it's the grass in the that we saw in this previous level. And it they apparently hadn't solved the puzzle before, but... so I didn't solve that part. Danji88. Oh, he's playing? Dan's awesome. Let's see. Oh. How do puzzles work in ROM hacks? The puzzles in this are not based on new mechanics. They're more based on, like, your ability to figure out what the clues mean and how they apply to the level. So, for instance, the first clue was about, like, you might have, like, missed something if you didn't find... it just said the D. And so the clue was referring to... there was a part at the end of the previous level where it just said the end, and the letter D in end was where the clue, the next clue was hidden. And then the next clue was like, Lamau, go touch grass. And there's a level with some grass in it. Okay, we have to ditch Yoshi. I don't know what I'm... I think I'm just going across the bottom there. I don't know. That's where looking at a replay would really help, because I'm not exactly sure what the play right there is. Thou who didst not check the D. They remind me of more, like, escape room style puzzles, I guess. It looks like Dish Yoshi up top and go through the bottom is Mario. Oh, okay, that makes sense, because the gate's up top where Mario can't get through. I'll see if I can make that happen somehow. This is, like, my weakest part of Kaizo Mario, is, like, interpreting some of these things. Chubb that had the best D clip. Chubb always has good clips. I hit it too high. Yeah, okay. I should have paused here before. Yeah, okay. The Yoshi, I have to bounce off of the Koopa, re-grab the Yoshi, ditch the Yoshi up in the top right where the gate is, and then swing back around and actually go in the bottom area as Mario. That definitely is what it is. Jumping all the best place. Aw, shucks. Aw, shucks. I walked right off the edge. Now you check the outer cliffs. Excellent. Have you played Keytastrophe? Yeah, I have a full playthrough of it up on YouTube. I really like Keytastrophe. It was great. Yeah, it's not OBS he's looking at. He's looking at the Twitch replay because it'll be a little delayed. OBS isn't delayed enough where I would look at it. Unless his OBS is delayed more than mine. Mine's delayed like a half a second. It's not enough to see stuff. Oh, I didn't land on it. Just the dashboard screen. Yeah, that makes sense. Just cheats? Yeah, Just does cheat. He cheats by being smart at the game and talented and then doing really well. Cheating. Why didn't that jump? Oh, I have to be holding right to get the jump. What is that? Alright, I gotta be- the corners are dangerous. Gotta be careful about those corners. Munchers normally eat. Are they carnivorous plants? Or are they just pokey? Like, maybe they're just living their best life and we're just slamming into them for no reason. Like a cactus, you know? It's kind of interesting because there are some plants that are, like, there are actual carnivorous plants that can eat, like, insects and bugs and stuff. But then, like, there are plants that are like, well, there are plants that also don't like citrus plants, like lemons and oranges and shit. Don't they produce that stuff to try to deter stuff from eating them? And of course, we're like, it tastes good, and then we eat it anyway. It's like, I love the way it burns. Grapefruit is like, I love the way it digests me. We just eat it anyway. Same thing with like capsaicin and spicy things like peppers. It's like, damn it, I'm gonna burn you. Stop eating me. And we're like, burn me harder, pepper friend. Speaking of spicy food, D, we gotta get some more spicy food. All right, ditch the Yosh, bounce on there, throw the ocean there, go down here. I mean, are we gonna... Okay, I'm gonna hold jump. And then I'm gonna bounce on that dude. You know what's gonna get me is the Yoshi physics here, I think. I don't know what's gonna happen, YOLO. Oh, that was actually it. It was just a piece. Oh my gosh. That was actually it. It was just a piece switch. Absolutely, yes. Is just action Australian? How does he play upside down and backwards? Always funny. Just like an off-screen thwomp. Always funny. This game doesn't have enough off-screen thwomps in it. Like, Barb has fish dialed in. Okay, Barb is a fish master, but this game could have used a few more off-screen thwomps. Yoshi ditch. Oh yeah. Yeah, if I made this hack, this Yoshi would. If I made this hack, you would die anytime the Yoshi dies. I've reformed my ways. No more gratuitous Yoshi murder. Dang. Hey Rackwall, welcome. All the hacks, all the thwomps this hack are off screen until they aren't. Yeah, but I want like a complex setup. Like, I want like arrows pointing everywhere. Like, it looks like the section is gonna be ridiculous, and there's like all these moving parts. And then an off-screen thwomp just hits you while you're sitting there thinking about it. Like, that's a good troll, all right? You can have that one for free next time, Barb. There you go. To be fair, the way that Barb uses fish is basically like off-screen thwomps. There we go. We have to go fast. Ah! Oh, right, all right, fair. Yeah, this section is just fun. Now that I've gotten used to the physics, it's just really fun. Gotta go faster here. Oh, there we go. In there. Heck yeah. What in the world is this? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Myself. Oh, I see. Alright, so I can like, can I just straight up jump on it? Okay, that's what it wants me to. Why does this Yoshi? Oh, I mean, I think I understand what I'm, hold on, this delay is awkward. Yeah, the delay in that is kind of awkward. I think it wants me to do something like this. Yeah, the delay is super awkward on it. Boom! I think I saw a pipe over here. Hello? Yeah, there's a pipe up there. Hey, Carl. Yeah. What's up, Shove? Do you have something funny to do with this? Because this thing is... Wait. You see that tongue? You guys just see a tongue? I saw a tongue. I swear I saw a tongue for like a second. Here we go. Aww. I was trying to appreciate Chavda. Come on, Barb. Aww. I like how Chavda just gets this like amazing, gorgeous picture, and everybody else has like all of the pictures that they wish that they could delete from the internet. Oh my god, I'm like sitting on my leg. Can you go back in the pipe from that room? Here, let's try. Yeah, I found Tofu. Alright. Well, yeah, that's the thing though. Like, Barb couldn't. Barb was like, alright, this is too much. I gotta be a dick somewhere in here, and then that's where that happens. This Yoshi is sick, but I love all these cool Yoshis. I don't think I can take the Yoshi with me though. Nice. Oh, sick music. Vertical auto-scroll. Easy game. Easy game. No! I was doing so good, come back. I was doing so good. Oh. I didn't shoot a thing to land on right there. Oof, gotta wait a little bit on that one. Before I remove their tongues to make them more powerful. Aw. It takes a little bit for this one to fire, which is like, takes a second to get used to, I feel like. You gotta like, kind of fire early. Okay, was there a platform here? And I can get that. Oh, get another Yoshi right there. Then we go back over there to the ride. It's criminally underrated how the music doesn't reset on death. Zaiden, I've talked about that. Like, I think it's one of the things that made Kaiser ROM hacks. Like, they would not be popular, in my opinion, if you couldn't do that with the music. It used to be that you had to go all the way back to the overworld every time. Every time Mario died, it's like not good at all. Was I supposed to? Oh, I can't jump on those. Yeah, like it would interrupt the music. You'd go back to the overworld. It was so bad in so many ways. Barb even used to like be a purist about that too. But the fact that the flow of the music doesn't break when you die is so huge. I don't know if I'm supposed to jump. Nah, if I just jump sooner, it'll work, I think. I'm just kind of jumping too late. I was gaming for a second, now it's all gone. Maybe I can jump immediately upon landing instead of swinging back out. Try that next time. Yeah, what if I just, like, jump? Yeah, that's the play right there. I died. I call a Rhino Yoshi a Ryoshi. Levels are so good so far, they are. And I'm supposed to jump onto that and then up there. Oh, and then do one of those and then do that. Shoot that lower though. Alright. Damn, this is so fun. I don't want to stop playing, but I need to go eat dinner. Getting kind of hungry. This is really fun, though. It's, like, hard to stab. I keep thinking I'm going to jump onto that black block because I don't play enough ROM hacks to know that you're just... Those, like, really dark-colored blocks, you're just never supposed to jump on them, even with Yoshi. So it's like not ingrained in my head. So I always like, oh, I'll jump on that. And I'm like, wait, no, I can't. That's why I keep missing that jump up. All right, bring this block over here. No. Just ignore dinner. shit. Oh, I have people to eat dinner with, so. Probably shouldn't. I would, if it were just dinner, I'd ignore it, but ignoring people for video games is not usually the play. A little bit delayed right now. Oh, hey, I didn't grab the block. Fab, this is the last level, unless the next one is cool. Grandpa with 3 doesn't come out every day. It's true. Oh, I gotta stop turning back right there. Oh, we might be okay. No. Just stream at the dinner table. I just want to get on this Yoshi, alright? Unamas. Oh, so close. Oh man, this section is just extremely fun to play. D, is this, I don't know if you're still here, is this another one of your Yoshis? Or did this one exist? Oh, look at that. That was so close. Didn't Pooh stay home? Oh, I think he had like D&D or something. Thank God this came out so I didn't have to go to that party. Oh, maybe that was something else. Oh, D, you made this? That's so cool. If anybody wants to say thank you to D for all of her amazing work on creating, for instance, all these cool Yoshis, could we get a link to D's Patreon? Yo, let's go. What am I doing right there? I don't know what I'm doing right there. Who had D&D the other day? Thank you. Oh, you posted. Yeah, okay, good. Yeah, so D does a lot of the assembly programming for this stuff, like for these Yoshis, to make cool Yoshis for us to play with, for Barb to play with. Rip. Oh, I'm so sorry. I missed a sub from like. Oh no, I missed 200 bits from 200 years ago. I'm sorry. I have a new stream set up, so everything's kind of awkward. Hanable, thank you for the 200 bits. Says, I was watching Barb go through clips of Grand Prix World 3 for YouTube, and your clips were hilarious. Thank you. I appreciate it. If you like watching silly YouTube clips, I have a bunch of YouTube compilations of me and tons of other streamers playing through other ROM hacks. So does JustCook as well. If we get some YouTube links, that'd be good. But those are some of my favorite videos that I've ever made, and I just fucking laugh my ass off rewatching them all the time. It's just some of the like best memories of doing silly stuff on stream. It's such a fun time. But yeah, I made my own hard ROM hack called Fly Me to the Stars, and there's a great compilation of that. Oh my gosh, I gotta do that and wait. Z-Tonic, thank you for the sub, and Wolfen, thank you as well. Hello from YouTube. Welcome. Very good to have you. I am gonna have to go eat dinner in just a sec here. But this has been extremely fun. There we go. That's the timing that we want there. Now, what's this setup? This thing setup just... It says air... Maybe that's what it wants. Oh, maybe it wants that, actually. Because Yoshi won't be able to fit through the top gap area. Yoshi, like, I think a one pile gap is, you, even if you duck, it doesn't even do anything in Super Mario World, I don't think. But I have Mario Maker poisoning, so I can't remember sometimes what's real and what isn't anymore in actual SMW. But I think that Yoshi can't fit through a one tile gap with Mario. So maybe the arrow is the indicator right there. That just works. That has to be it. Oh, this is going to go up. Oh, I love this trick. I made a... Oh, and if you goes to... Oh, that's cool. Look at that. I made a ROM hack called Just Cooked Alive. And it uses that as a troll. And oh my gosh, one of my favorite parts of it. That's... I have another streamer reaction compilation on YouTube of that whole thing. It's really good stuff. Block, thank you so much for the sub. I appreciate it, everybody. I might still be okay? I think I'm okay. Alright. This is a cool setup because it just kind of works. Like, I'm like, there's no way this is gonna work, and then it just happened. Okay. Oh, the Yoshi isn't in the blocks! So when Yoshi is inside of any wall, the game tries to eject Yoshi by like teleporting up through all the blocks. I didn't shoot a fireball. My people need me. You love Carl's toilet. And There were a bunch of really funny troll rum hacks. Jez made a couple great ones. MM102 did as well. Yeah, that 102 level was so good. Oh. Juz, I have... I don't know if you would be interested. I gotta stop telling you to do things. I'm sorry. I know you. We both do it, whatever, but... But I have, like, 70% of a fucking banger troll level in SMW. Maybe... Ugh, I don't know. If you ever want to work on it together, we could both... Maybe we could both release one, because we'd never do it otherwise. But it's so hard. Yeah, no, it's got some good shit in it. D made some amazing stuff that I don't want to go to waste either. But I just don't have motivation, which I'm sure you can understand. I've got like, even Maddie, like Celeste creator Maddie, freaking coded some. I'm gonna spoil this, all right? If you don't want to listen, just mute for 10 seconds right now, okay? I'm giving you a chance to mute for 10 seconds. But, okay, so Maddie coded pipes that suck you in. So basically, I'm going to chase the player with pipes, and it's going to like siphon them into it, and it's going to take them somewhere that they don't want to go. And it's like, it's such a fucking hilarious setup and a hilarious troll. Oh my god. But yeah, it's just, Lunar Magic is so hard and so long and whatever. I don't know, if I could get someone to work with, maybe I would actually finish it. God, it's fucking funny. Yeah, it's really funny. Maybe I could build it on stream. I don't know. If I had someone to work with, I would actually do it, I think. See, Juz, then we can make a compilation without having to make Invictus 2. I are done with Grandpa 3, hit you back up to excellent. Is Grandpa 3 putting out some emergency updates? I don't know if anything was like super broken. Oh no, not this again. Why does that happen? Is that a thing? You probably watch building it on stream. It might be fun to build on stream. Maybe I get Barb to play it. maybe if I beat Grandpa World 3, I could get Barb to play it. Otherwise, like, oh no, we're gonna need a 1.1. Like, there's no way that I'm winning marbles. And if I did win marbles, I would have Barb play an old, what was it, a fucking Commodore 64 game or something? What was the Atari? Called Rick Dangerous. shit. It's like, it's some hot trash from like 1989. It's good shit. Dan Salvato, like, rolled up with- Oh, it's Amiga! Amiga! That's it, that's it. Dan Salvato was just sitting there at GDQ with this fucking 1980s Amiga console, getting people to play- Like, it was like Mario Maker Hot Garbage, okay? But on the Amiga. Is that the whole reason that that's programmed like that? I need to know. Is that the whole reason? just for that right there. Fuck. Oh my god. That's hilarious. I love that so much. You saw Tom. Oh, alright, I really, really need to eat dinner, but I also really want to get to this next area. Oh my god. I need to stop. No! I'm pushing too many buttons. That was an accident, but if I recall correctly, I asked Barb if I should fix it. He was like, no, that's hilarious. Yeah, that's basically my response to it, too. It is hilarious. If that's for your part where you hit yourself to make it run faster. maybe it was like a byproduct of that. Oops. Oh, we're still good somehow. Okay, let's not screw this up. No, come back! Come back! Come, oh, I might have been okay. Looks like I jump up there and then we shoot another fireball. What a cool section. A little far out there. Dang, I gotta put the Yoshi further to the right. I mean, I don't have to. I think I could still get it from there, but it would certainly make my life easier if I did. I know, I'm so close. I'm on it. I keep releasing and repressing run, and it's killing me right there because it accidentally shoots a fireball. Like, if you're not already holding the run button, it's gonna shoot a fireball. So I need to just, not release the run button or something? I don't know. Oh, that's why I released the run button, to throw that. I remember now. Because that time I held the run button, but then I just got stuck with that block. I don't want to do that. That worked. A little bit weird, but it worked. Uh-oh. No! Are you having fun? I'm having tons of fun. This has actually been awesome. Bar made a fun game. Yeah, that's the way to do it. There we go, there we go. Alright, let's do this. There we go. Oh, no! I should have waited. I couldn't see what was happening yet. I should have just waited a second. Actually, we're like too speedy, I think. That's a nice way to do that section. Alright, cool. I keep purposely rubbing the wall right there because it kind of sets, well, it sets that up to be right next to me. And I'm like too afraid it's gonna change if I go faster there. And then I spoke. Spit, did you see that? The mouth was open! The mouth was open! It just didn't come out! You gotta wait a sec for the fireball to like come out of the mouth if you ditch Yoshi too fast. Also, this Yoshi needs a name. If you ditch Yoshi too fast, then it doesn't happen. Uh-oh. Alright, that still worked out. Might still be okay. Not anymore. Gotta drop my, gotta drop my gem. Naming him Gregory. There we go. Can I get that? Trolls, 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 no trolls. All right, let's go. Yeah. Get in there. Let's go. That was a very, very fun level. And there's more. Oh, it's another. I have to just take a peek, but then I need to go eat. Tempo Temple. I just want to see if it's another Yoshi level. I mean, it's kind of, I'm feeling like a dinosaur prehistoric vibe right now. Whoa. Okay, no, there's no Yoshi. We studied the results and finished with green Yoshi. Okay, it was, right? It was yes. Blockitus, Zingonic, and Zwolfen, thank you so much for the subs. It's greatly appreciated. Thank you so much for coming out, everybody. If you missed my part one of this, I got it up on the old YouTubes on the main channel. If you're interested in compilations of streamers getting trolled by some Kaizo, I released my own hack, Fly Me to the Stars, with a compilation for that. And I have another compilation video, Carl vs. Juz. I don't know what that YouTube video is called. I don't have a link for it, so good luck. Let's go find someone who's playing Grand Prix World 3 to raid. We're gonna go raid a wonderful streamer named Chainbo. I don't know where Chainbo's at, but Chainbo's a very good Kaizo player and a very nice guy. Check him out. Thanks for coming, everybody. Thanks for coming, Absalom. Thanks, Lazy Dev. See ya, Limon. See ya, Moist Cushion. Bye, Sable. Thanks, Overlord. Bye, Source Code. Bye, Allison. Bye, Gonzo. Bye, Shaka Dweeb. Bye, Narcotis. See you later, Nova. Bye, everybody. Thanks, Block. Thanks, DJ. Thanks, Willy. Bye, everybody. Bye-bye.